even odd analysis of tapered coupled line hybrid. In the previous video, we have introduced the basic structure of tapered coupled line hybrid coupler, and we said that it is composed of two straight line sections of characteristic impedance Z0 connected to a tapered coupled line section, and this tapered coupled line section had a characteristic, an even characteristic impedance Z0 even, which start with Z0 at the two output terminals and reach to the value Z0 over K at the section or the intersection between the tapered line section and the straight line section. On the other hand, the odd characteristic impedance Z odd has a characteristic impedance at the output terminal Z0 and characteristic impedance at the intersection with the straight line sections of Z0 multiplied by K. We are going to study the even and odd circuits separately. We have two options, either to excite from port 2 and 4 or to excite from port 1 and 3. So we start with excitations from port 2 and 4. In this case, we are going to assume that for the even circuit, port 2 and port 4 are excited by V0 over 2, V0 over 2 with the same amplitude and phase, while for the odd circuit, it would be excited at port 4 by V0 over 2 and port 2 at minus V0 over 2. For the even circuit, we are going to take just the lower half circuit, for example. And in this case, the reflection coefficient at the intersection between the tapered line section and the straight line section would be called gamma E dash. Gamma E dash in this case would be the impedance seen at this point minus the characteristic impedance at this point. The characteristic impedance at this point is Z0 even at Z equal L, which is Z0 over K. So the reflection coefficient gamma E dash would be Z0 minus Z0 over K over Z0 plus Z0 over K, which can be simplified as K minus 1 over K plus 1. This reflection coefficient is the reflection at the intersection point. However, if we are interested in finding out the reflection at the input port 4, so this would be the reflection after passing a phase shift theta in the forward direction and phase shift theta once again in the backward direction. So the value of the reflection coefficient gamma E at the port 4, the even reflection coefficient at port 4, it would be gamma E dash multiplied by e to the power minus 2j theta. This term, e to the power minus j2 theta, corresponds to the phase shift due to the traveling of the wave along the tapered line section, one in the forward direction and one in the backward direction. In a similar way, the reflection coefficient of the odd mode at the intersection, gamma dash odd, would be the impedance Z0 minus the characteristic impedance at this point, which is K multiplied by Z0. So this would be Z0 minus KZ0 over Z0 plus KZ0, which is simply 1 minus K over 1 plus K. Once again, the reflection coefficient at port 4 due to the odd excitation, gamma odd, would be gamma odd dash multiplied by e to the power minus 2j theta. which is 1 minus k over 1 plus k multiplied by e to the power minus 2jc. Now we have the even reflection coefficient and the odd reflection coefficient due to port 4. By adding these two terms together, we can obtain the total reflection coefficient at port 4 of this tapered coupled hybrid line cut. On the other hand, if we are subtracting gamma even minus gamma odd, we obtain the reflection coefficient at port 2 due to the excitation of port 4, or the transmission due to at port 2 due to the excitation at port 4. So from gamma even and gamma odd, we can say that the total reflection coefficient at port 4 S44 is half multiplied by gamma even plus gamma odd. And according to the value of gamma even plus gamma odd, we can note that S44 is 0. Or in other words, the port 4 in this tapered coupled hybrid is matched. On the other hand, the signal at port 2 due to the excitation from port 4 can be obtained as half of the reflection coefficient of the even mode minus the reflection coefficient of the odd mode. So S24 is half reflection coefficient gamma E minus gamma odd. By taking the difference gamma E minus gamma odd, it would be K minus 1 over K plus 1 multiplied by E to the power minus JC, 2JC. So in this way, we have obtained S44 and S24. Because of the symmetry of such tapered hybrid coupler, we can say that in a similar way, we can prove that S22 is 0. And also because of the symmetry, S24 equals S42. So from this, we can obtain S22 and S42. If you are interested in finding out the transmitted signals to port 1 and port 3, we start with the even circuit. For the even circuit, we are going to take the lower section. This lower section can be represented as a transmission line section of characteristic impedance Z0 with a phase shift theta connected to a transformer with a transforming ratio square root k to 1, such that the input impedance seen after the transformer is Z0 over k, which is the characteristic impedance of the even characteristic impedance at the intersection between the two lines. Then this impedance Z0 over k is connected to a transmission line section of Z0 of length theta, and this would be connected to the terminated load Z0. So it is required to find out the voltage at port 3 due to the voltage at port 4. At the beginning, we can obtain the voltage at the beginning of the transformer to the voltage at the end of the transformer. Then the relation between the voltage at port 4 to this point is e to the power minus j theta, and the voltage at this point to this point is another e to the power minus j theta. So if we can obtain the transmission coefficient of the transformer, we simply multiply by e to the power minus j2 theta to obtain the total transmission coefficient. This transmission coefficient can be obtained in terms of the corresponding ABCD matrix of the transformer. The corresponding ABCD matrix of the transformer, the value of A is square root k, and the value of B is 0, the value of C is 0, and the value of D is 1 over k, over square root k. From this ABCD matrix, we are going to convert this ABCD matrix to scattering matrix, and from the scattering matrix, we are only interested in S21, which is the transmission coefficient. The transmission coefficient in terms of the ABCD matrix is 2 over A plus B over Z naught plus C multiplied by Z naught plus D. By taking the value of A, B, C, D here, we can obtain the transmission coefficient as 2 square root K over K plus 1. So this is the transmission coefficient of the transformer, which is actually this part. This is the transmission coefficient of this part. It's going from a taper transmission line section of even characteristic impedance Z naught over K to a transmission line section of characteristic impedance Z naught. Now, the total transmission coefficient from port 4 to port 3 for the even circuit, it would be this value of T multiplied by e to the power minus 2g theta, which is the phase shift due to the first line, plus the phase shift or multiplied by the phase shift due to the second line. So the even transmission coefficient TE would be 2 square root k over k plus 1 multiplied by e to the power minus 2g theta. In a similar way, we can obtain the odd transmission coefficient of the tapered covered line section. Instead of using the even characteristic impedance, we are going to use the odd characteristic impedance, Z not odd. The transformer, the corresponding transformer for the odd characteristic impedance is the value of A is 1 over square root K. This was in the case of even square root K. And the value of B is 0, the value of C is 0, and the value of D is square root K. Once again, in the case of the even, it was 1 over square root K. From this transformer, which is a junction between the tapered line section and the straight line section, we can find out if this transmission line is Z naught, the impedance seen at this point is K multiplied by Z naught, according to this transformer ratio, which is 1 over square root K, which is actually the odd characteristic impedance at this junction. Following up the same steps, we are going to use the ABCD matrix of this transformer to obtain the transmission coefficient through the transformer. So the transmission coefficient once again is 2 over A plus B over Z naught plus C Z naught plus D, which is exactly the same as in the case of even circuit, is 2 over square root 2 multiplied by square root K over K plus 1. Now multiplying this transmission coefficient by the phase shift e to the power minus g theta due to the first line, multiplying it by another phase shift e to the power minus g theta due to the second line, we can obtain the transmission coefficient of the odd circuit T odd as 2 square root K over K plus 1 e to the power minus 2g theta. Now we have the even transmission coefficient and the odd transmission coefficient. We have the even transmission coefficient and the odd transmission coefficient. If we are going to add the even circuit with the odd circuit, we obtain the transmission coefficient for port 3 with respect to port 4. So S34 is half the transmission coefficient of the even plus the transmission coefficient of the odd. So this plus this multiplied by half, it would be 2 square root k over k plus 1 into the power minus gc. On the other hand, if you are interested in finding out the transmission from port 1 to port from port 4 to port 1, instead of adding, we are going to subtract. So the even transmission coefficient minus the odd transmission coefficient will obtain the transmitted signal at port 1 due to port 4. So S14 is half even transmission coefficient minus odd transmission coefficient and according to this value it would be 0. So now we have S44, S24, S14 and S34. Actually we have the complete column of the scattering matrix due to port number 4. We have S14 is 0, S34 is 2 square root k over k plus 1 e to the power minus 2j theta. S24 we have already proved as k minus 1 over k plus 1 e to the power minus 2g theta. And S44 it was 0. Okay. We are now interested in the value of the transmitted signal from port 4. From port 4 to port 2 and 3. Here port 1 is the isolated one because S14 is 0. So the bar is divided between port 2 and port 3. We are going to take the amplitude or the magnitude of S34 and we are going to call it beta. So beta would be the magnitude here, which is 2 square root k over k plus 1. And as I mentioned, the value of k is greater than 0 and less than unity. So this value is actually greater than 0 and less than unity. In a similar way, the magnitude of S24, we are going to call it alpha. And alpha in this case, it would be minus k minus 1 over k plus 1. Why minus? Because, as I said, the value of k is smaller than 1. So, k minus 1 is negative, and I'm talking about the magnitude. So, negative by negative, this is positive. And in this case, the magnitude of alpha, or the value of alpha, is greater than 0 and less than 1. If we take the value of S24 squared, the magnitude of S24 squared, plus S34 squared, which is alpha squared plus beta squared, if we added this squared plus this squared, we find out the magnitude is unity, which means that the total bar from port 4 is divided between port 2 and port 3. And nothing is reflected to port 4 and nothing is transmitted to port 1. So, the bar conservation, all the power going from port 4 is divided between 2 and 3. According to this definition, we are going to present the fourth column of the scattering matrix of such tapered cable line section. In this case, S14 is 0, S24 is minus alpha multiplied by e to the power minus j 2 theta, k minus 1 over k plus 1 is minus alpha multiplied by e to the power minus 2j theta. And S34 is beta multiplied by e to the power minus 2j theta. And finally, S44 is 0. So, according to the analysis of the even odd analysis of ports 2 and 4, we could obtain the fourth column of the scattering matrix of such hybrid coupler as is. Actually, from the symmetry of the problem, we say that if we are exciting from port 4, we obtain from port 2 minus alpha e to the power minus g theta, and from port 3 we obtain beta multiplied by e to the power minus g 2 theta. And there is no power at port 1. Okay? So, instead of using port 4, if we are using port 2, if we are using port 2, the power will be divided between port 4 and port 1. And port 3 would be isolated. So, from the symmetry of the problem, we can obtain the second column. In this case, the second column would be as follows. If I'm exciting from port 2, the power will go to port 4 as minus alpha e to the power minus 2g theta, such that S42 is the same as S24. S42 is the same as S24. On the other hand, the power going from port 2 to port 1 will be the same as the power going from port 4 to port 3. So S12 would be the same as S34. S12 is beta, S34 is beta e to the power minus g theta. S22 is matching as S44 is matching. So S22 is 0. And S32 is 0 because the port 3 is isolated from port 2 as the port 1 is isolated from port 4. So S32 is 0 as S14 is 0. So now we have two columns of the scattering matrix. In addition, this matrix is symmetric. So from the symmetry of the problem, we can say that S12 equals S21. S14 equals S41. This is actually symmetric. Once again, S12 equals S21. S14 equals S41. Okay. S34 equals S43. S34 equals S43. And what is else? Yeah, this one is this is not symmetric. What is else? What do you think? Let us see. Yeah, S21 equals S12, S14 equals S41, S32, S34 equals S43, and this one it was S32 equals S23. So now we have all these components of the scattering matrix. We have only the remaining one is, what is S11, S31, and actually from the symmetry, S13 equals S31, and from the symmetry, S11 equals S33, because this board is similar to this board. This means that it would be also required to study the even odd analysis once again, but instead of exciting from port 2 and port 4, we are going to excite from port 1 and port 3. This will be used to obtain the reflection coefficient at port 1, and from port 1 we can obtain the reflection coefficient at port 3. And we are interested to find out the transmission from port 1 to port 3, so S13 or S31. That's what we are going to do here. Even an odd analysis of Tweber's double line section here, port 1 and port 3. It is the same steps, but the excitation now is going from port 1 and port 3 here, V naught over 2 and V naught over 2, and here two matched circuits for the even. For the odd, here V naught over 2 minus V naught over 2, and here two matched circuit, and following up exactly the same steps as in the previous example. So following up the same steps, we can obtain the reflection coefficient of the even mode is 1 minus k over 1 plus k e to the power minus 2 j theta, and the odd reflection coefficient is k minus 1 over k plus 1 e to the power minus 2 j theta. From this two reflection coefficient, we can obtain the reflection coefficient of the total circuit at the port 1, S11 is half the reflection coefficient of the even mode plus the reflection coefficient of the odd mode, which is 0. So the reflection coefficient at port 1 is 0. On the other hand, the transmitted signal from port 1 to port 3, it can be obtained S31 as half the reflection coefficient of the even mode minus the reflection coefficient of the odd mode, minus half multiplied by gamma e minus gamma odd. By taking gamma even minus gamma odd and taking half the value, it would be 1 minus k over 1 plus k e to the power minus 2 j theta, which is actually the value of alpha multiplied by e to the power minus 2 j theta. So now we have S11 and S31. We are going to apply this S11 and S31, S11 here and S31 here. So this would be 0, alpha. Now, from the symmetry of the problem, S31 equals S13, and from the symmetry of the structure, S33 is the same as S11, so this would be equal. So, from the symmetry of the problem, we obtain S13 and S33. So, this is a complete scattering matrix of the Tabor coupled line hybrid. It can be noted here that the coupling coefficient between the two boards have ratio alpha and beta, where alpha is 1 minus k over 1 plus k, and beta is the square root k over 1 plus k. And it is interesting to note that if the signal is going from port 1, it is divided between port 2 and port 3 in phase. And if the signal is going from port 4, it is divided between port 2 and port 3 out of phase. So this is classified as 180 degree hybrid coupler. If the signal is going from port 2 and port 3 simultaneously, they are going to add at port 1, and they are going to subtract at port 4. So if we are going to excite port 2 and port 3 simultaneously, they add in phase at port 1, and they are going to subtract at port 4. This is the analysis of Tabor coupled line hybrid coupler, or 180 degree hybrid coupler based on Tabor line section. By this end, we have completed the analysis of different coupler configurations in this chapter. In the following video, we are going to discuss qualitatively other configurations of directional couplers, different directional couplers. The analysis in the following video, or the discussion in the following video, will not include any more analysis. So this is the final analysis in this chapter.